പ്രിയജനമേ ഞാൻ പോകുന്നു മെഴുതിരിയേന്തും മാലാക മരണരഥത്തിൽ വന്നെത്തി ഒടുവിലെ യാത്രയ്ക്കായി പ്രിയജനമേ ഞാൻ പോകുന്നു മെഴുതിരിയേന്തും മാലാക മരണരഥത്തിൽ വന്നെത്തി പരിമിതമാമീ ലോകത്തിൽ കടമകളെല്ലാം തീരുന്നേ പരമപിതാവിൻ ചാരത്ത് പുതിയൊരിടം ഞാൻ തേടുന്നേ നെറുകയിലൊടുവിൽ മുത്തുമ്പോൾ കരയരുതേ നീ പിടയരുതേ മൃതിതൻ പടികൾ കയറുമ്പോൾ തുണ തരണേ നിൻ പ്രാർത്ഥനയാ സ്മൃതികളിൽ എന്നെ ചേർക്കേണേ ഒരു പിടി മണ്ണിൽ പൊതിയുമ്പോൾ ഒടുവിലെ യാത്രയ്ക്കായി പ്രിയജനമേ ഞാൻ പോകുന്നു മെഴുതിരിയേന്തും മാലാക മരണരഥത്തിൽ വന്നെത്തി പരിമിതമാമീ ലോകത്തിൽ കടമകളെല്ലാം തീരുന്നേ പരമപിതാവിൻ ചാരത്ത് പുതിയൊരിടം ഞാൻ തേടുന്നേ ഒടുവിലെ യാത്രയ്ക്കായി പ്രിയജനമേ ഞാൻ പോകുന്നു മെഴുതിരിയേന്തും മാലാക മരണരഥത്തിൽ വന്നെത്തി സ്നേഹം തന്നൂരെ പ്രിയരെ ദേഹം വെടിയും നേരത്ത് മിശിഹ തന്നുടെ നാമത്തിൽ നന്ദി പറഞ്ഞു മടങ്ങട്ടെ നന്ദി പറഞ്ഞു മടങ്ങട്ടെ നന്ദി പറഞ്ഞു മടങ്ങട്ടെ
and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God our Father
and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I bless the body of Father Lijo with the holy water that recalls in his baptism of which St. Paul writes, all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness of his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness of his resurrection. Your response is, the Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
The Lord is my shepherd in your kingdom.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayer and be merciful to your son, Father Licho, whom you have called from this life. Welcome him into the company of your saints in the kingdom of light and peace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy for us, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Show compassion to your people in their sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength to lift us from the darkness of this grief, so that the peace and light of your presence may shine upon us. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us, conquered death, and by rising again, restored life. May we then go forward eagerly to meet him, and after our life on earth, be reunited with our brothers and sisters, where every tear will be wiped away. We make this prayer, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother, Father Licho, to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the Eternal King. Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angel of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself, and may angels lead you to Abraham's side.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Give Father Lucho eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Father, into your hands we commend our brother Father Lucho. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. You give him this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assistance and assurance of our faith. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
My dear Archbishop, fathers, brothers and sisters, Father Lijo would have been a priest on the 27th of this month for 10 years. And in this short span of time, he has served the Archdiocese of Nagpur in the capacities that he was placed. He was assistant in the cathedral for 2 years. He went to do his master's in journalism, another 2 years. He came back and then was in SFS school, helping out the principal. And from there, in 2018, he was transferred as manager at Narket, the upcoming school, St. Francis de Sales. He came with this COVID to Nagpur on the 13th of this month. And on the 14th, he was taken to Alexis Hospital with Father Dominic Simon for a CT scan. The CT scan showed a score of only 4, which the doctor said need not have hospitalization. Taking medicines and being quarantined at home would suffice, the doctors said. And so he was brought to the Archbishop's house, where he was getting better. I personally met him on Saturday, last Saturday. He appeared very cheerful. He showed no problems at all. And on Sunday, I got a call from Father Thomas to tell me if I can get a place for Father Lijo, whose breathing problems have increased, in Shanti Bhavan Hospital. Dr. Jain was kind enough. Somehow or the other, he made a place. And Father Lijo was admitted to the hospital where care was being taken of him. We used to get, the bishop and I used to get every day the updates of him through Father Ranjit, who served him very faithfully, taking food 3-4 times a day. towards 3 days ago, Father Ligio complained of a little breathlessness. The doctors were going to put him in the ICU there. At that time, Father Isaac was not feeling well at all in Muir Memorial Hospital. And so he was being taken to Chandrapur to be taken care of to Christ Hospital. And Father Joshi was very kind enough to give him a place. And so Ligio also said to Thomas that I would like to go there. And so arrangement was made and he was taken by another ambulance to Christ Hospital at Chandrapur. I used to only get from Chandrapur information through the phone. So I would request Father Joshi, the director of Christ Hospital, to let us know as to what his condition when he came and how they did their best to help Father Ligio to overcome this disease. Father Joshi.
Dear Archbishop, my dear fathers, brothers and sisters. So on 21st evening, he was brought to Chandrapur Christ Hospital. He was having breathlessness in a high degree. And the CT scan score, which was on 14th at 4. We had no scan in our facility and we could not shift him for scanning because he was having so much of breathlessness. So we suppose the scan score has been raised at least to 20 from in a span from 14 to 21st within this short span of time. Whenever he was out of oxygen, as he was getting down the vehicle ambulance, he was having a lot of breathlessness. So all of a sudden we put him into ICU. We supported him with NIV support and he was on NIV till yesterday night. He had problem of asthma and asthma has terribly caused his lungs damaged. And the damage which has caused to his lungs, that has been the main reason for this untimely departure of Father Ligio from us, from our communion. From 21st till yesterday, Father Thomas and few of the fathers from Nagpur, they were, before yesterday they came, yesterday also they came. Both the times I took them to the ICU, I showed them. He was in full consciousness. He was sensing whatever is happening. He was very, what we say, very reactive to the external support. So that what happened, you see a swelling on his eyes. As he had this asthma problem, whatever he was breathing out with high pressure, and that has caused that swelling on his eyes because the mask, it was pushed up like this. There is a swelling on the eyes. And our foot were okay. Still he had some problem in the side of creatine. It went up little. Urea also went up. So in that such condition, yesterday morning, maybe by 12 o'clock or 11 o'clock, I contacted Father Thomas. Then we were planning to shift Father Ligio any of the tertiary center, either in Nagpur
or in Hyderabad, anywhere else. Just yesterday, from 4 to 8, this planning was going on. As I understand, including the Archbishop, the fathers in Nagpur, they were searching for hospitals in Nagpur. And in Hyderabad, St. Teresa's, actually a bed was booked. And there was a plan to shift him by air ambulance to Hyderabad. And even the timing was fixed by 11 o'clock. Everything was almost scheduled like. And at the last moment, air ambulance we could not get. But then we were planning to shift him to Nagpur. A bed was getting arranged that they were planning to take a ventilator from St. Joseph Hospital to Bokod, I think. That was the last plan. And we were really waiting for the ambulance by 8:30, 9 o'clock. So at 9, we were just going to have the supper. We were in the dining hall, in the presbytery there. We took our meal. All of a sudden, we got a call from the hospital. It is in the same campus. His oxygen level has stooped down, so much down. So we all rushed into the ICU. And doctors were trying their level best to support him, to help him, to revive him back to normal life. But all the attempts as part of plan of God, we say, failed. All the attempts failed. And from 24 hours, whenever we were taking the oxygen mask, whenever he was taken out of the support of the NIV, his O2 level was dropping down to 35-40. So we were actually just feeding him some juice. He could not sit and eat something because the support was so much necessary to have him with us. So that was the condition. The damage which was on his lungs, plus the asthma that he had, that has caused this great loss for all of us. We thank for the life of Father Bijo. I don't know him personally, just two times maybe I have seen him. But I have heard about him. I know what is the depth of loss of Father Bijo as a person physically to the archdiocese and to the priests here, to the ladies here. Thank you. He is a man tall, a man with all, and he had a lot of contacts. Such a man at this young age. So that way, the loss of him for all of us, for the archdiocese, is a great loss. But God has great plan in this great loss of us also. So we trust in the plan of God. We surrender ourselves, we surrender the soul of Father Lijo to the highly qualified plan of God. And let us pray for his soul, let us pray for his family members, his mother, sister, her family and brother. I also personally pray for him. I also convey our condolences, especially our Bishop Ephraim. He has conveyed his condolences. He told he would come yesterday night to say pray, but it was already late, 11:30. And early morning we left. So he wished to come and pray, but he has prayed, he has conveyed his condolence to the Archdiocese. So let us continue to pray for Father Lijo, and we firmly believe the place which has been set apart for him, he has occupied it, and he is there to pray for all of us. May God bless us.
This, brothers and sisters, the deep sorrow in my heart, I joined with, along with our priest, to all his family members who have gathered in their parish church, and as they participate in this funeral rite, I deeply feel for his family, for the great loss, not only for theirs, but also the Archdiocese. In our capacity, we did all that we could. And as Father said, it's only up to our limitations we try to reach out. Today, as we pray for Father Lijo and pray for his near and dear ones, we sympathize and say these words of comfort to you, my dear family members, to his relatives and near and dear ones. We surely assure you that we will keep you in our prayers and continue to pray along with Father Lijo. And he is in a better place today in heaven to also intercede for us. As we go through these difficult times, the pandemic all over the world, I'm sure the Lord will grant him eternal rest. And may he rest in peace.
ഞാനും വിഗ്രഹം തേടി ദൈവത്തോടു തുറന്നിടാ എത്തുന്നേ ഞാൻ നാഥന്റെ ചാരി കിട്ടുന്നുപ്പമുണന്നിടാ കരയുന്നോ നിങ്ങൾ ഇന്ദിനായി ഞാൻ സ്വന്ത ദേശത്ത് പോകുമ്പോ കഴിയുന്നു യാത്ര ഇത്ര നാൾ കാത്ത ഭവനത്തിൽ ഞാനും ചെന്നിതാ പോകുന്നേ ഞാൻ എൻ ഗൃഹം തേടി ദൈവത്തോടു തുറന്നിടാ എത്തുന്നേ ഞാൻ നാഥൻ ചാരി പിറ്റുണർന്നിട
Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our brother Father Lijo peaceful rest in this grave. Until that day, when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise him up in glory, then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
since Almighty God has called our brother Father Lee Joe from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our brother to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise up his body on the last day. Let us pray for our brother, Father Lee Joe, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom." We ask this in faith. Your response is, "Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give our brother, Father Lee Joe, eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother, Father Lee Joe, was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray together the prayer that our Lord taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, listen to our prayers for our brother, Father Lee Joe, as he always desired to do your will. So in your mercy, forgive whatever wrong he may have done. By his Christian faith, he was united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy, give him a place with your angels and saints. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Give him eternal rest, O Lord.
And
the divine assistance remain
with always. Faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
You, Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
വസ്ത്രമോരിഞ്ഞ ആറടി മണ്ണിലാഴ്ത്തവേ ഭൂമിയെന്നൊരാക്കൂടുവിട്ടു ഞാൻ സ്വർഗമാം വീട്ടിൽ ചെല്ലവേ മാലാഖമാരും ദൂതരും മാറി മാറി പുണർന്നു പോ ധന്യമാ പോകുന്നേ ഞാനും എൻ ഗൃഹം തേടി ദൈവത്തോടൊത്തു ഞാനെന്നാഥൻ്റെ ചാരി പിറ്റെന്നു പമുണർന്നിടാ സ്വർഗരാജ്യത്തിൽ ചെന്ന നേരത്ത് കർത്താവിനോട് ചോദിച്ചു സ്വന്ത ബന്ധങ്ങൾ വിട്ടു പോന്നപ്പോൾ നൊന്തുനീറിയോ നിന്മനം ശങ്ക കൂടാതെ ചൊല്ലി ഞാൻ കർത്താവേ ഇല്ല തെല്ലുമേ എത്തി ഞാനെത്തി സന്നിധേ ഇത്ര നാൾ കാത്ത സന്നിധേ പോകുന്നേ ഞാനും എൻ ഗൃഹം തേടി ദൈവത്തോടൊത്തുറങ്ങിടാ എത്തുന്നേ ഞാനും നാഥൻ്റെ ചാരി തിറ്റെന്നൊപ്പമുണർന്നിടാൻ